Hello.
What's up, thrill seekers? So today I am going to be sharing with you my top 10 roller coasters at Six Flags Over Texas. So really quickly, there are two coasters that are going to not be on this list, and that is La Vibora or La Vibora, depending on how you think it's said, as well as Wildy Coyote, Grand Canyon Blaster, I think is what it is. I did ride La Vibora, but I did not ride Wildy Coyote, just because they don't allow me on Wildy Coyote because it is a kiddie coaster. And La Vibora, it does not make the top 10. So yeah, anyways, let's get into the top 10 coasters at Six Flags Over Texas. So starting it off with number 10 is Mini Mine Train. This coaster is pretty okay. There's not anything too special about it. It's just a solid mine train, definitely for littler kids, but I like that they let people like me on it that may be a little bit taller. Whoa, this looks really weird. Hold up. There we are. Yeah, I'm happy that they let me on it, but anyways, it's just an okay coaster, nothing too special. It's kind of boring, but it's there. Number 9 is Runaway Mine Train. Now, this is definitely a better mine train than Mini Mine Train. It is actually decently intense for a mine train, not like Roadrunner Express style intense, but more. It's definitely a long ride. There's like a whole bunch of lift hills. I think there's 3 from what I remember, and it's a long ride, and there's a little surprise at the end which gives you a lot of airtime. So that's always good. And yeah, overall, it's a good mine train. Happy that it's there. Of course, I don't really see why they need to have 2 mine trains, but it's there, and it's a solid mine train. Number 8 is actually Batman the Ride. This coaster is, of course, a clone. It's a classic Batman the Ride clone, but it's definitely the worst Batman the Ride clone that I have ridden. It is insanely rough, a whole bunch of head banging, and even if you put your head forward, you still will like bang your neck, which does not feel very good. So really, the whole time I was riding it, all I could think about was ow, 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 and I wasn't able to actually enjoy the ride experience, which is not something that I enjoy. So that's why it's super low on this list. I know some people actually like it. One of my GP friends, Matthew, you might have seen him in the Six Flags Fiesta Texas vlog, but he's the one who was screaming on Poltergeist. But anyways, he actually does like this coaster. He thinks it's one of the best at Six Flags Over Texas, and I personally disagree. So yeah, next coaster. So at the number 7 spot, let me get back onto the, okay. So at the number 7 spot is Judge Roy Scream. That is their old classic wooden coaster at Six Flags Over Texas. It's a pretty good ride. The first ride that I ever had on it was pretty rough, and I didn't really get any airtime or anything. And then I rode it again, and I actually did enjoy it, and I got a decent amount of airtime. Just a decent amount of floater airtime, which is pretty good. I personally like floater over ejector, so yeah. Yeah, it's a good coaster. It's definitely rough, and it's definitely like an old woody, like classic out and back type of coaster. So it's not anything insane, but it's definitely just a good ride that I recommend you going on if you're at Six Flags Over Texas, and like even just not for the credit, like it's actually a good ride. You should go on it. Number six is Pandemonium. It is a cloned spinning coaster by Gerslauer, and overall, I really like these clones. I think the one at Six Flags Over Texas is a little bit different. I'm not 100% sure how, but I'm pretty sure it's some sort of like thing where it's a little bit taller, a little faster, or something like that than the normal. Than the normal Pandemonium clone, which I guess makes it better, but like it doesn't really do too much. You can't really notice it. But I like these coasters. I love just like the spinning wild mouses in general, and this one is no different. It's definitely one of my favorite like spinning coasters. I've not really been on any intense ones like Time Traveler or anything, but of the ones that I've been on, Pandemonium clones are definitely up there. And yeah, it's a good coaster. Get some airtime during kind of towards the end of the ride, which is super awesome. And yeah, it's just a solid family coaster. Number five is Joker, and this is a classic 4D free spin clone at pretty much every single Six Flags park now. And they are pretty good, honestly. I'm not really complaining that they're cloning them. Of course, I would rather them build original coasters versus just clone a whole bunch of non-original coasters. But Joker clones are pretty decent. I have never had any big like problem with them. And this one is no different. It's definitely one of my least favorite. It's probably like middle tier in terms of Joker clones or Free Fly clones that I have been on. But yeah, it's just pretty decent. Definitely something that I would go on again and probably would try like once every time I go to Over Texas, just because it's like a solid coaster. But yeah, that's Joker. Now getting into the big top four, this is kind of like the main four coasters. Starting it off with Mr. Freeze Reverse Blast. Now just something that I have to say, this Mr. Freeze is way, 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 way worse than the one at Six Flags St. Louis. The one at Six Flags St. Louis is actually in my top 30. This Mr. Freeze probably barely makes my top 40. So there's not really similar at all. Well, of course, it's the same layout. It's actually a mirror image from what I remember. But overall, it's for sure worse in my opinion. It's just a lot rougher, a lot bumpier, and the scenery around it isn't as good at the one at Six Flags St. Louis. There are a whole bunch of trees and everything where, you know, you go up the spike and you have a beautiful view of the hills and of all the coasters. The one at Over Texas kind of just was slapped on a pile of dirt from what it seems like. And it's definitely, like I said, more bumpy than the one at St. Louis. But yeah, that's Mr. Freeze. It's still a good coaster. Definitely will ride it every time I go to Over Texas. Definitely like a must ride. And the reverse launch is great. I always love backwards launches. They're definitely unique and kind of definitely different than a forward launch, which I didn't really expect the first time because I was like, oh, it'll kind of just be really similar, but it had a totally different feel, which is cool. And of course the spike is great. You get a little bit of airtime on it, but not as much as the one at St. Louis. Anyways, yeah, that's Mr. Freeze. Number three, really getting into like the super good coasters here, is Titan. Titan is a really good coaster. It's a hyper coaster, the only one in Texas. So it's definitely unique to Texas. It's one of the two major Giovanola coasters. That's Titan and Goliath. And for sure, Titan is better than Goliath at Six Flags Magic Mountain. It's just a longer ride, first of all, just because it has a double helix before and after the mid-course break run. Speaking of, the mid-course break run is definitely the worst part of the ride, just because it really, like, completely stops you, completely in your tracks, at least pretty much. Maybe sometimes it will stop you more, and sometimes it will stop you less, depending on when you go, how many trains they're running, all of that kind of stuff. But no matter what, it really breaks you hard, which kind of sucks. Although if you are in like one of the front rows, then you kind of hang over the edge. You kind of hang over the edge a little bit, which is pretty cool. But yeah, it's a good ride. Get some good airtime on the airtime hill after the first turnaround. Definitely gray out every single time on the helixes. One time I blacked out, actually. I just kind of, everything closed in, and then it was just dark for a solid 2 seconds before we hit the mid-course break run. But super forceful. If you really like forceful rides, then this is for sure a ride for you. I've actually heard arguments from people who like forceful rides that this is the best at over Texas, but I prefer airtime over intensity, so I would have to disagree. But speaking of airtime, let's get into the top two, which are both super airtime packed. Starting it off with number two is Shockwave, and that is the Schwarzkopf Looping Coaster at Six Flags Over Texas. It's a super good ride. Get plenty of airtime. The restraints are decently like loose on you. They really, like, it's hard to get stapled on this coaster. So you always get insane airtime, which is great. On the first drop, you get good airtime. On the loops, you get great intensity. And then on the second turnaround, you go through the loops, you turn around, do a little dip, and then you turn around again. When you drop out of that second turnaround, you get literally standing airtime. The first time I rode this, the lap bar was super loose, and I was completely standing up, which is pretty scary, but pretty awesome. Of course, it's still safe, like the lap bar was still kind of hitting me, I didn't like fly out, and also you have a seatbelt as well. But you get some insane airtime on this coaster, which is why it is decently high in on my list of coasters that I've ridden. And yeah, it's a great coaster. For sure recommend it. It never gets a long line, which is great because you can really marathon it as much as possible. And yeah, that is Shockwave. Now to the number one coaster. I'm sure everybody predicted it. It is New Texas Giant. New Texas Giant is the RMC coaster at Six Flags Over Texas. It's actually the first ever RMC coaster. So yeah, they definitely hit it out of the ballpark on their first try. It's in my top 5 coasters that I've ridden, I'm pretty sure. If not, then definitely in my top 10. And it's just a great airtime packed coaster. There's no inversions, but that doesn't take away anything from it, in my opinion. The first drop is insane, especially in the back car and especially in the back row. You get insane airtime. And definitely try not to get stapled on this coaster, because if you don't get stapled, then that drop is 10 times better. Just great airtime all around. I mentioned earlier that I like floater airtime and flowjector airtime versus straight up ejector airtime. And this is definitely one of the few RMCs that focuses, in my opinion, more on floater and flowjector airtime versus straight up ejector airtime, which is why it ranks so high for me and why it is one of my favorite RMCs, I think number 2, just behind Steel Vengeance. But it's a great ride, for sure recommend it. I mean, you definitely have to ride New Texas Giant if you go to Six Flags Over Texas. Sometimes it'll get a long line, but even that, it's like usually on a decently crowded day, it maybe gets 30 minutes to an hour line, which is not bad. And if you really don't want to wait in it, then just get a Flash Pass for it. If you have a membership, then just get a Flash Pass like individually, or if you're not, then just get a Flash Pass, and it'll be definitely worth it. But anyways, that is my list for top 10 roller coasters at Six Flags Over Texas. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, smash the thumbs up button and definitely leave in the comments below, what is your top 10? Do you agree with me on certain points? Do you not agree with me? Did I just make you rage and throw your phone at the wall? Tell me in the comments below. I definitely want to hear all of you guys' opinions. And for sure, check out my Six Flags Over Texas vlog right there up in the corner. Yeah, definitely go check that out. I had a great day at Coaster Kids Day, Worldwide Coaster Kids Day at Six Flags Over Texas. Speaking of, hey. But yeah, definitely go check that out and check out all of my other park vlogs in the park vlog playlist, which I'll also put right there. And yeah, that's gonna be it for the video. Like I said, smash the thumbs up button, subscribe if you're new, and I will see you guys all next time. Peace out.